is a documentary on Philibert Grits, the mysterious enigma that is rumored to now live out instead. An ex-lion tamer, Philibert could no longer perform his job due to a severe stage fright and fear of crowds and people in odd numbers. Philibert tried to tame the lion a few years ago at the San Francisco Zoo, but was then arrested. Now, Philibert is rumored to be training and whispering to animals in front of young children, and creating an army of squirrels to eventually exact revenge. Philibert was never a normal child. Born a 10.5-pound baby, he never seemed to fit in with anybody. Perhaps this is why he eventually resorted to befriending animals.
So you want to know about Philibert Grits? Let me tell you about Philibert Grits. Okay, I work at the veterinary hospital in this area, and that idiot brings in every kind of godforsaken animal you can think of. And you know what? He brought some in today. For a time. Four freaking animals. No appointment. No nothing. He brings everything in pairs. Do you know how big you can get a group of animals to bring in pairs? Ugh, if you even call them animals. For example, this is supposed to be some kind of Siberian husky cat from Siberia. We told him that she wasn't, pretty much just looks like a normal cat. However, when we were trying to do the blood test to show it to him, she scratched me. So most of his animals are freaking mean. There's a rumor going around that he has like a whole army of squirrels. All I have to say is he better not, because if they're anything near as mean as this cat, we're done. Global domination, people. Oh, and then there's this thing. Ugh. Supposedly it's some kind of African toad. Does it look like an amphibian to you? Oh, God. Last time I checked, they didn't have fur, and they didn't make that sound. And, God, I didn't think that toads were so slimy. Oh, my favorite. He called and told us that there was going to be an African panda coming. This is what came through the door. Does this look like a panda? This doesn't even look like a baby panda. I don't even know what this looks like. And then my personal favorite, the mysterious creature in the bucket. It was supposed to be This is what I pulled out of the bucket. How do you think you feel about that, looking for a tadpole and seeing something that's red and hellacious? Anyway, if you ask me, I think Philibert Grits is bad news. Part of me hopes he has a giant army of squirrels. Maybe they'll attack him. But until that happens, I'm stuck with him and his $17,000 vet bill that he hasn't even come close to paying. So if you see Philibert, tell him to call me, because I'm sending his ass to collections.
Hi. I'm Miss Revenue Nevada. I'm here to tell you about Philibert Grits, apparently, which I don't know why. I'm the important one. I mean, look at this. Do you realize what it takes to get this? Do you know how many horses you have to ride? And that man calls himself an animal whisperer? Puh! Are you kidding me? What in the sad hell is he thinking? I mean, for real. He came to...
Sorry.
That doesn't happen to a rodeo queen all the time, but I'm so poised and graceful, I can just recover like anything. Anyways, I'll move myself forward more carefully. Philibert Grits came to my stall one time. insisting that he ride my horse. Of course he fell. Are you kidding me? Man's a city slicker. He lives in a cardboard box. How many real country people do you know that live in a cardboard box, with the exception of the people in the trailer park? But I wouldn't really call them real country. That's more redneck. Philip Grits is not the man he says he is. Squirrel army nonsense. That's another thing! A squirrel is an urban animal. How many squirrels do you see out in the desert where the real horse whisperers live? None. So Philbert Grits is a big fat phony. If he really knew how to whisper to animals, he would have this title. But there's no rodeo king, Philbert Grits. And even if they were, you wouldn't be it.
Hey guys, I just wanted to let you know that that guy's not a dog whisperer, and I really just don't want him to come near me ever again, okay? So if you could just, oh my god, is that him? Oh my god, you guys, can I get out of here now, because I'm getting freaked out, I don't want Philbert to find me, please, please.
Hey you guys, my name's Guido. I was just stopping by to let you know that I know Philbert and he is a hot little number. However, I'm pretty sure he can't read my mind. And so if you could just disregard anything he tells you about Boston Terriers taking over the planet, that would be great.